Joining me today is Gavin Anderson, Deputy Attorney in the Salt Lake County District Attorney's Office, to give us an overview of how open meeting and open record laws affect the general public in Utah. Welcome, Gavin. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you, Alex.
Gavin, why don't we begin today by you telling us the significance of open record and open meeting law?
Sure. Open records and open meetings laws are sometimes referred to as sunshine laws because they basically require the government to conduct its operations and activities in the sunshine. It's really the basis of an open government. It's the basis for the public understanding what the government's doing. And it's all about transparency. Some people feel very strongly about it, consider it just as important as the First Amendment.
Now, why should a Utah citizen care about these laws?
Well, for a citizen to actively participate, to knowingly participate in government, they really need to know what's going on. And so both grandma and the open meetings law give that ability to an ordinary citizen to find out what their government's doing.
Now, do you think an ordinary citizen knows or cares about these laws, or is it mostly for the media?
Well, it's interesting. You'd think most of these issues come up with the media. And frankly, I think more open records, open meetings requests come from commercial sources. A lot of them come from individual citizens. And to answer the questions of whether an individual citizen thinks these are important, there was really a very interesting case that came out of a bill in the Utah legislature in 2011 called HB 477. And it started out by making some limitations on grandma and making some records harder to get hold of. And there was a very, very strong public reaction, not just from the media, but from citizens in general. And that statute was that was passed by the legislature. It was vetoed by the governor.
Interesting. So how can a Utah citizen find useful information through this law?
Well, basically, they need to know where to go, and there are websites for an open meeting. Nothing is better than to actually go to the meeting, especially if it's a matter that's something of interest to you. But I think it's just to become informed. There are both websites and other opportunities for people to find out about these meetings, and they just need to know where to get them.
How is Utah different from other states?
Well, Utah's open meetings law goes all the way back to pre-statehood, all the way back to Civil War era. And that's kind of unusual for most of the states. Nowadays, almost all the states have open meetings law. One of the exceptions, interestingly enough, is Pennsylvania, which does not have such a law. At the other end of the spectrum, you have California has a state constitutional amendment guaranteeing open meetings and open records.
So is Utah like FOIA, for example?
It's very similar. FOIA, the federal FOIA law, came out in the 1960s and provided for free access to federal government records. But frankly, it's a lot more limited than Utah's open meetings, open records laws are.
So you mentioned earlier, Gavin, that there's some examples where these laws have been very important in high-level profile news coverage. Can you give some examples of that?
Sure. One of the best examples is the Utah Supreme Court case that came out of a sexual harassment investigation in a county office. And the county had conducted an investigation regarding that complaint, and the newspapers wanted to have access to that investigative report, and the county was not very forthcoming in making that available. The newspaper took it all the way to the Supreme Court, and the Supreme Court decided that basically governments need to be more open, not less open, and need to be more willing to provide records and to live by the Open Meetings Act.
Very interesting. Thanks for joining us today, Gavin.
Thank you, Alex.